Hello, my name is Paul Garrett from Orbis Software. I would like to give you a short demonstration now of how TaskCentre can interact with Dynamics AX. You can see in front of you, I've got customer records in AX and there are six customer records. I'm going to show how TaskCentre can update these through the Dynamics AX web services. I could equally be calling any of the other web services in Dynamics AX and updating any other object, creating objects, deleting objects, retrieving objects. But I'll show you an example of customers now. I'll just switch to another VM where I've got TaskCentre, and here I've got some tasks that I could run, but this particular one, create customers multiple, I've created in advance or templated. I'll just open him up, and I've partially pre-built this task, and I'm just going to show you how I complete this task. In this task, I've got a schedule step, which is running periodically. That could be any other event in TaskCentre, like changes in databases or emails arriving or workflow or something like this. Following that event, I've got an XML document import, which is taking an XML file on disk and processing it into TaskCentre. Now, down here, you can see the XML file that I'm going to process in. This could have been created by any other system external to both AX and TaskCentre. And in this particular case, I've got new customers with two customers within them with their relevant data. And you can see that one is in Southampton in the UK and the other one is San Francisco in the US. Just close that. This document import could equally have been any other type of step that's going to retrieve data, so it could have been another web service step or a database query or some other type of file import. Now I'm going to create a new step in here, a new execute step, a web service tool step, and in this case I'm going to consume the data from a previous step, the output from the XML document import, the file I just showed you, and I'm going to call onto a web service, and the web service I'm going to call into in this case is called that one, and there I can have a complete list of all the web services that are available within AX. I just need to point it at the relevant ones that I want to make available to TaskCentre. And I'm going to create records is my operation I want to perform there. It could be a delete operation, an update operation, or just a retrieve operation. And then I'll open up the mapping tab and I'll just enlarge that so you can see what's going on here. Here you can see that XML file I showed you earlier with new customers, with the customer records within it, with each of the data. That's the shape of the schema of that data. So there could be many customers within here, many customer records. And over the other side here on the right hand side, you can see the operation that I want to perform into AX, so all of the data elements that can be updated within AX. Now for each customer on this side, I want to create a customer table entity on this side, so I'm just going to drag customer onto that customer table, and now it's telling me that some of the names of the elements on this side match the names of the elements on that side, and would it like me to automatically map those for me? I'll say yes, because that'll save time, and in this case it's mapped almost everything across, and it's created a simple loop between the two sets of data. Now I know that in my input data set the currency hasn't got the same set of codes as I'm using in AX, so I'll just remove the simple mapping that I've got between those data elements, which I could just recreate if I wanted to, just to show you. You can just manually map as well. So just remove that manual mapping. And I'm going to create a table lookup between those two sets of data, and to do that I'll just use these functions. And I'll just pin my functions so that keep them available. And I'm going to create an internal lookup table that maps between the two. So currency, if I drag that into there, and currency is what I want to map across to. And if I double click on that internal lookup, I've got a table within there. And in that table, I can say that when the value sterling occurs on my input data, I want to create a code GBP. And when the value US dollars occurs in on the left, I want to create USD. I think there should be a space in there. And say OK to that. I could add as many entries as I want into this table, and it just creates a simple translation between input data and output data in this particular function. And that's now my data mapped from one to the other, and I'll say OK to that to save that data and just join my steps up in the sequence that I want them to occur. And here I've got a save as file step, which is capturing the output from that web service. So when I send that data to the web service, it's going to respond with some data, and the data it responds with in this particular case would be the customer numbers that it's created, because the customer numbers are automatically generated in AX. So if I just say OK to that, that's that task completed. And now if I want to run that task, I'll queue it now. Ordinarily it would run on the schedule, but in test mode I can just choose to queue it. And you can see down the bottom here that the steps are running in that task. And that's the task complete, everything's turned green. So now if I go back to AX and I just refresh my data there, you see two new entries have appeared for two customer records. There's Acme, which is my GBP in Southampton, and my other record is my San Francisco address, also translated. So that's how TaskCentre can easily update data into AX. It's just drag and drop, point and click, simple, with transformation functions to change data where you need it to be transformed. And it can be used for many different purposes: integration, automation, workflow. I hope you enjoyed my demonstration. Thank you.